Howdy. Something I can do for you?
Is anybody else in the house except you?
Well, no. My grandson is over there. Hey, what are you gonna do?
Don't let on, but there's someone in the barn.
What makes you think that?
Well, I heard a horse in there. And it ain't one of ours either. I can tell by the way he's acting, too.
All right, come out of there. You know this man? Have you ever seen him before?
No, sir, I haven't. That ain't the man that did this.
Sounds like you know that country pretty good.
Like my own ma's cooking. Marshal, looks like you got yourself a real bull to wrestle.
Well, it just so happens that the man on that wanted poster was named Haggen. Blackjack Haggen. He wouldn't be any kin of yours, would he?
That's your feller, all right, Marshal. My Uncle Jack. I've been trailing him for pretty near 2 months now.
What are you trailing him for?
Cause I aimed to catch him and put a bullet through his head. Might be a bigger joke on the kinfolk, though, if I was to help bring Uncle Jack in to get him hung. They'd just never get over it if I was to do a thing like that. Well, let's go get him, Marshal.
You're the only honest, Haggen.
Folks, sure.
You know, when I was born, I had real big ears. Me and Fergus both.
Fergus, who's that?
My twin brother.
Hold it! Get your hands up.
Shoot a hole right straight through your head.
You go crazy? The man said under arrest. You up in the law?
Well, it's lodged right in there again, the bone, Marshal. It's gonna take a sawbone to get it out.
I wonder what your pa would say now if he knew he raised a boy that turned again his old flesh.
You've been mouthing off for 10 minutes now. Shut up and eat.
Real Haggens used to say, like three peas in a pod. Festus, Uncle Jack, and Fergus.
You shut up about Fergus. Can't you get it through your thick head? He told me what you done to him. I'm fixing to kill you right where you're standing.
Festus.
You open your mouth one more time. One word, that's all. I loved that boy like a June morning. You went and got him killed. Led him into a trap and got him shot. Shot bad with his leg broke.
I hate to say this, Marshal, but I've helped bury men that look bad.
The handshake still goes?
Well, of course it does.
You're not letting all this talk of his get to you?
Oh, no.
You better stay in out of that hot sun.
I wasn't going with him. Honest.
They watch me all night like hawks.
Yeah, but he's gonna miss them keys.
Morning.
You're
You're gonna be sorry that you didn't get in on the winning side. Getting hung ain't winning. The man ain't born yet that can take me in.
Jack, take them horses and get out of here.
Shut up. So you was gonna watch him hang me, was you? Well, you ain't fit to be a Haggen. Just like that milksop brother of yours. Your pa would be the first one to say so. You ain't gonna watch him hang me because you ain't gonna live that long. Marshal, what if you're hanging? Now, we'll decide, Festus, can come last. Ah!
Festus, what about you? What are you gonna do?
Well, I just don't rightly know. I ain't a Haggen no more, I reckon, after what I've did. I'm just gonna have to do a little banking.
I wouldn't, Sonny.
How long you been sitting up there?
You listen to our private talk? Who are you?
That'd be none of your business, I reckon.
Seen you around Dodge in a long time.
Mr. Dillon? Kitty?
Yeah.
Doc?
Yes, sir.
Guess who I just seen? Festus Haggen.
Festus?
Hi, Festus.
Marshal.
Howdy, Festus.
Well, I'll get me a drink and I'll come over and sit with you.
Good.
What are you ogling at? Answer me!
Where's Festus?
He's in there.
Marshal?
That girl, Guthrie's girl, is there something wrong with her, Marshal?
Well, I'll tell you the best I can. The way it happened, he thrown me down real hard in the bushes and clapped his hand over me.
I warned you to stay away from her.
Golly Bill, Marshal, she come to me.
I know what you mean, Marshal, about something a lot worse than throwing me down. You mean like kissing and all. Mr. Haggen never done nothing like that.
You all know that every time one of them wolfers comes in to Dodge, we got nothing but trouble.
Looks pretty bad, don't it?
We got about 10 or 12 drunks in that lynch mob already. That might be enough.
Yeah, it sure might.
And you know it. You shut up, Guthrie. I ain't gonna shut up. I ain't gonna let Sarah tell them all by herself. I'm gonna...
You shut up!
You shut up! I ain't gonna leave it for Sarah to tell them.
Stop.
I tell them I... I sure tried.
You done fine.
Festus, you're free to go.
Obliged, Marshal. Ma'am, I'm sure plumb sorry to hear about your pa.
Where are you going, Mr. Haggen?
I kind of figured I'd make me a little trip down to Texas or someplace, maybe get a job of trailing some cows.
Festus, you'll be coming back, won't you?
Oh, I reckon I will one of these days. Fact is, you can pretty near count on it, Marshal.
this is my last lonesome living bill. And...
Good evening, gentlemen. And good night, all.
He sure cleans you like a pit chicken.
I can afford it. A glass of water. In a clean glass, if you please.
Bucko, I'm afraid you'll have to come with me.
Well, you ain't got no call to act like that. Treating me like I was a killer or something.
I see you're missing a button off your vest, huh?
By golly, I did lose one, didn't I? Hey, I'm right fond of you.
Here he is, Mr. Dillon. He just now got back to his house. What's all of this? Oh, howdy, Festus.
Chester?
You back again? Just trying to figure out here how I could stop Doc from... Why don't you drag up a chair and rest your feet?
Oh, I don't think I can hang around that long.
Oh, well, Mr. Dillon will be back pretty soon, I guess.
Got a dozen guns on you. All right, turn around.
Now, I'd like to say that doing one's duty is not always a pleasant chore. But decent, honest citizens have got to support the demands of justice.
You wouldn't know justice if it snuck up and bit you in the seat of the pants.
She'll get hurt.
No! Let me down! Stop it!
Thanks, partner. Drop it!
Pop decided to tell the truth. Curly, he told us the whole story.
Pop can't be relied on. He's getting a little soft in the head.
Save your breath. We found the money in your room.
Now, Pop, you old fool. I warn you.
How far north you plan to ride?
When you're looking for land with water on it, you ride till you find it, Clara.
Let it get out. Buddy, I want you to do something for me. I want you to go over there and hide in that brush. Hide real good and don't say a word until I call. You understand?
What's wrong, Mommy?
Nothing, dear. There's a stranger riding in from the prairie. We have to be careful.
Allow me.
Look, my husband. Who are you?
My name's Festus Haggen, ma'am.
Go away.
Come on now, I'm trying to be your friend.
Now I can have a drink. Had to stay sober just so as I'd get the drop on you, Cassidy. But everybody's taken care of now.
What are you saying?
I killed your wife.
You?
And that rotten kid of yours. She seen me, so I killed her too last night.
Not here.
You're the most obliging customer I ever come up against.
Then you bring it all on yourself.
Hey,
I'll swear you're the onlyest young'un I've ever knew that was dumb as a camel.
What's a camel?
You want me to go away?
Oh, don't start that again. I'm on to you. Swear the only...
So long, you fine bunch of fools. For you, Marshal.
What's that?
Out at the ranch. I killed her pa, too. Come pretty close to wiping out the whole family, didn't I? Pretty close.
I think I better go out on the ranch and check up on this. Take your hair with you.
All right, man.
Men. Haul him out of here, will you?
One minute.
I don't have a home anymore, do I?
Well, just don't you worry about that, none. We'll find you a place to live. Till we do, you can stay right at Ma Smalley's house.
Walk me back, Festus. I'd rather not go alone.
Sure.